bottles and bottles of bubbles. Girls with tattoos who like getting in trouble. Lashes and diamonds, ATM machines. Buy myself all of my favorite things. Been through some bad shit, I should be a savage. Who would've thought it turned me to a savage? Rather be tied up with girls and the strings. Write my own checks like I write what I sing.
Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Barbie. Yeah, it's your girl Barbie. It's your girl Barbie. I just came up with that intro. I know it was really cheeky, but so guys, in my makeup look somehow, I just finished doing a makeup challenge. I think the video will be out before this one. So I just wanted to kill two birds with one stone. So that's why the brows are doing their thing and I'm doing my thing, and I don't care. I have to bring out content for you guys because the girl has taken enough break. Start to go back to work. Work, 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 work. So guys, today I'm doing a really funny video. And it's just for fun. I just felt like having fun today, so I'm doing this video. This game is called the Crazy Girlfriend Test. So I want to know if I'm crazy or am I a calm girl? So I wrote the questions down and I'm going to read the questions out and like. And not subscribe to my channel, make sure you click that subscribe button because we are going to the top. We are the hookers on the top. So if you want to go to the top with host, make sure you click so that you will be one of the people that will be tossed from the beginning. Don't you want to be there from the beginning? Good. I know you want to be there from the beginning. So you click it. You click the subscribe button. You like this video. You know, because I'm waiting for you. Click it. Click it. It won't even take anything from you. You get like, it will not take anything from you. Just click subscribe. Subscribe. Click that thumbs up and you like it. Yes, guys. I'm sorry, but if you know me, I'm sanguine. Yeah, I'm sanguine. Right now, I'm so happy. Because, you know, my new hair is all flicky. Like, my girl hooked me up with some braids. Okay, let's get into this video. But make sure you like this video, subscribe, and yes. So the first question said, would you be okay with your boyfriend having a best friend of the opposite sex? No. No, I will not. I'm sorry, but I won't. I'm supposed to be his best friend. He's well. But see, I don't think I will have a problem with him having friends that are girls. But the problem here is best friend. Like, why am I not his best friend? Because that best friend will be the one, like, when he's quarreling with Barbie, it's the best friend he wants to be like, oh, you know what Barbie did? And girls, they won't even sugar it, you know, they'll be like, oh really? Is that what she did? I don't know, but no, because I'm a kind of person that if I have a friend and my friend is a guy and then he starts dating, I kind of push away to let the girlfriend feel like she can have more closeness with her boyfriend, I think, because that will help them to be more, you know, close. I just think so. Would you, second question, would I be okay with my partner having a celebrity crush? I don't think I have a problem with that because we've never seen her. So you can crush on whoever you want to crush on her, Naya, because I'll be crushing on my own too. Yes, though. Yes, boo, yes, boo. But then it's really always tricky to me if, like, your partner now has a celebrity crush that looks opposite to you. Like, I'm big. Now you now have a celebrity crush that is like slim. But I don't care. You're crushing. Okay. Your partner smiles at a certain thing. Are you curious? Yes, of course. Like, what's making you smile? Let me see it too now. You don't want me to smile. Now I want to smile. So let me see it. You know? Yes, I'm curious. Even if it's in the class, like, answer this one. If you are in class and your classmate is laughing to something that nobody knows what is going on, you want to know, like, hey, guy, yeah, why are you laughing now? Sit with your partner, why are you laughing? Like, what's funny? Is it on my face? Whatever it is, you gotta tell me, you know. He wants to have a get together at his or her boyfriend's best friend's place. I decided to sleep over. Oh, I think I saw this question from a video of Shola and the patrons. And then I think the question had to do like they had a cookout and then he had to go with this certain best friend of his and they want to sleep over. I don't think I have a problem with it because I feel like there are going to be other people there. And even if there are not other people there, he should learn to be responsible, man. Because, you know, we cannot just come and be doing irresponsible dudes. Like, what? So, you went for a sleepover, you want to sleep over, and you now slept over. It's very obvious for him to be like, oh no, I can't sleep over. I have to go back home. Right? Okay. That was cranky, but obviously, I don't care. I don't care. Right there. Nah, I don't care. Okay. He likes and comments on the opposite sex pictures, like on Instagram. I think it doesn't matter because when it comes to social media and a relationship, I'm in the kind of perspective that it doesn't matter. If he likes pictures of people, he can like the picture, but commenting, what do you have to say? Oh, you're looking hot. Do you comment on my pictures? Oh, really? Oh, honey, is that what we're gonna do? We're gonna be commenting. Yes. Ni nada, esta ni vagina. He does not have to comment, but he can like. Like, no problem, like, oh, no, I like it. The pics is cute, like it. But if the pics is cute and you like the comment, oh, no, you have to come and comment on my own. You have to comment like, oh, you're fire. You're But seriously, he can only like and not comment. Like, true it though. Like, don't comment. If you comment, you come at me. You come at me because you have to comment. You're on fire. Baby, you lit. It's hot in a You guys, I'm just too happy. On a day, he sees his ex and they step aside to talk. Oh, really? You people have a finished business. What are you people talking about? I don't understand. I will not say anything. When he comes back, he will tell me the discussion. Me, is he coming back to sit down and not tell me discussion? You as a woman, you not stand up on me. Yeah. You're on your own, though. Yeah, I will leave for. Oh my God, laughing. But on a serious note, you're on a date with somebody, and then you will not see his ex. I stand up and say, you, if you're a boyfriend, I stand up and say that. What do you think you're talking about? Oh, baby, it's been a while. Oh, is that your girlfriend? She's beautiful. Oh, because, like, if you have an ex and then you still want to talk to your head, there's no problem. There's no problem. But we only didn't have respect. You can see the heads and then see the heads with more height. Then when you go back home, you go and talk to the heads. But it's me and you, yes. Oh no, baby, you don't do me like that.
So now, you will not stand up and leave me alone sitting down there.
Ah!
Auntie. Ah! Next question, please.
They work together or they are always together, like in the same classroom with his ex. I don't have a problem with that because I feel like you can't change the situation. Maybe like they were in a relationship together and they were working together. So does that mean because he's not dating you, he will not change his work and change his classroom? Ah, sister, you all need too much. Me, I'm not jealous like that. So yeah, I'm not crazy like that. But I don't see anything there. I'm trying to check my tab because I think I wrote that question here too. But I don't think there's anything there. It's like a situation you can't change. Do you get me? It's not something you can just stand up and be like, oh, you're working with her, but in the same class, once you change your class, like, really? Really? If he did that to you, would you be happy? You don't know that one day, God forbid, you will not become the ex. He will not be doing you one-sided dish. It's not as if you care, Shabbat. You know what I'm saying? To a party and you guys will be the opposite sex. I feel it all depends because when I was younger, I used to dance in my secondary school, and dance is just like a way, it's like a way of expressing oneself. It doesn't mean anything, but it depends on the dance. Like, are you dancing salsa? Is that what you're dancing? Are you people grooving on each other? That's when it gets more complicated for me, you know. But still, I don't care. It's just dance. You're expressing yourself, right? Express. We're not in Harley Express. Express yourself, you know. Ain't nothing there. Okay, the last question is, he still talks to his ex. Well, if this question should be more, you know, organized. Some girls are actually, you know, victims to this. You actually break up with someone, move into a new relationship, and you still talk to the old person. Maybe it's not that you like the person. It could be that you are still like trying to, you know, check up on the person. This was someone that the person was once in your life. I'm a kind of a different species of human being. I like, anybody that knows me knows I actually care for people a lot. And if you're going through something, that doesn't mean because we are no more friends, we are no more in a relationship, I'll just throw you out. I will throw you out, I'll check up on you, I'll always, because I want you to do the same for me. I don't know who is going to help me in a time of need or whatever. But if he talks to his ex, I don't have a problem with it. But the problem now is, how does he talk to his ex? When does he talk to the ex? What are you talking about? If she's like, let's say her mom was sick, and she's like, oh, my mom was sick, it's for every human being. If you have anybody in your life and the person is passing through something, check up on the person. Like, there's nothing bad there. But by the time my mom is finished sick, and she's like, oh, I miss the days that we used to take care of each other, baby. It's a no for me. But I don't have a problem with him talking to them. So that's all the question, guys. So you guys be the judge. Am I crazy? Or am I cool? But I'm kind of crazy cool. I really love my hair, like you guys. I really love my hair. And it's really, really so guys, that's all for today. But as I said, make sure, you know, check again. If you know what I mean, just check. Like, am I still subscribed to Barbie? Check. Let's be friends. Let's talk. You know, let's talk about things. Let's talk more. And yeah, that will be all for today. Baby, you people, I love you. Bye.